Now here's a quick look at the flash business headlines from overseas. The World Bank unveils a new scorecard that would allow its shareholders and the people it serves to measure and track the impact of the bank's lending and grants. The bank has been urged to increase transparency and accountability and improve how it helps countries address issues such as climate change and pandemic preparedness. The scorecard includes 22 global indicators, down from 150 on the previous instrument, for poverty, prosperity, and a livable planet, as well as themes such as gender equality. Moving on, the International Monetary Fund says domestic shocks in emerging economies in the G20 are increasingly affecting growth in the rich world. Spillovers have increased almost threefold since the early 2000s, led by China, while spillover risks from Brazil, India, and Mexico have also grown moderately. Across the G20 emerging markets, the IMF warned that average growth of 6% per year over the last 20 years would further slow. On to more news, UBS reportedly in talks to attain full ownership of its China platform. The Zurich-based lender is proposing to buy the 33% stake held by Beijing's state-owned assets management in exchange of UBS selling part of or its entire 51% stake in Credit Suisse Securities to Beijing government's investment fund. UBS put the Credit Suisse venture up for sale after taking control of its smaller Swiss rival when it collapsed last year. Meanwhile, HSBC selling its business in Argentina, booking a $1 billion loss on the deal. The business, which covers banking, asset management, and insurance, will be sold to Argentina's fifth largest bank, Grupo Financiero Galicia, for $550 million. The bank has sought to simplify the sprawling lender to improve performance by exiting several markets in which it has underperformed, including France and Canada. In other news, L'Occitane International's billionaire owner, Reinhold Geiger, nearing a deal to take the skincare company private with funding help from Blackstone. Geiger is considering offering a 20% premium over HK$26 a share. L'Occitane, which has a market value of about $5.6 billion, has seen declining profits in recent years. Meanwhile, Malaysian tycoon Vincent Tan also considering taking Kuala Lumpur-listed Berjaya Food private. Berjaya Food fully owns Starbucks Malaysian operations. It also runs other brands in the country, including Kenny Rogers Roasters and fresh soy milk operator Jollibean. Moving on, actress Jessica Alba set to step down from her role as the chief creative officer of Honest Company. The personal care and baby products maker says Alba, who is shifting her energies to, quote, new endeavors, would continue to provide her support and leadership as a member of the board. And finally, Paris Olympics on track to hit U.S. broadcaster NBC Universal's ad sales record after the pandemic. Comcast-owned NBCU said it has sold $1.2 billion in advertising for the Paris Games and is on track to achieve a new sales record in Olympic history. The company paid $7.65 billion to renew its broadcast rights deal through 2032, the largest deal in the world for the Games. 50 cubic meter per second water allocation given to water concessionaires Maynilad and Manila Water will likely be retained. The country's Water Resources Board earlier announced the allocation for Metro Manila will be reduced starting April 16, that's next week, from 50 cubic meters per second to just 48, in an effort to conserve water amid the prevailing El Nino. However, the Environment Department says a so-called water checkpoint at Angat Dam, which supplies about 98% of the metro's water needs, which will be conducted today as we speak, is likely to show that the water level is still above the 195-meter threshold and thus will not warrant a cut yet. Meanwhile, Maynilad says if the decrease in water allocation does push through, it will implement a reduction in the water pressure during off-peak hours.